Hi folks, Lance here from TriggerShims.com. In this video, I want to show you how easy it is to install shims in your Ruger American rifle. Now this is a Ruger American 22 rifle. It's been safety checked. The chamber's empty. The magazine's removed. Bolt's removed. There's no ammunition on the bench. We'll start with the two screws on the bottom of the stock that hold the barreled receiver into the stock. Of course, I've already loosened these up. So we'll just pull them out right here and lift the stock off the barreled receiver. Now here you can see that on the trigger housing assembly, the trigger and the trigger release or the trigger safety. What we're going to do to start with, we're going to take this little E-clip off right here. Now to do that, it's got some spring tension in it, so it can go flying and get away from you and get across the room. You'll never find it. So we want to carefully just get underneath it here. We want to push it up, and I want to cover it with my finger at the same time. There we go. So we can get it off there without it taking off on us. Set that out of the way where you won't lose it. In order to take the trigger pin out, all we have to do is kind of wiggle the trigger back and forth to take a little spring tension off of it and push the pin over to the other side, just like this, and there's your trigger pin. Set that aside. Now the trigger assembly still has some spring tension. The trigger tension adjusting spring or trigger return spring sets right here and it's pushing back on the trigger. So what we're going to do is we're just going to kind of wiggle it and pull it out all at once, and at the same time I'm holding the pin that holds the trigger safety or the trigger release bar, because that can just fall right out. There's not really anything holding that except where it was at in the trigger block, so we'll keep an eye on that. Now that's all there is to take the trigger out. There's the trigger return spring. Sets in just right like that. Now that sets in there right about here and sets against your trigger right like that. Okay, and it sets just about like that against your trigger. So we'll set that off to the side here. Now the first thing I want to do, this is a casting, and it's going to have some rough edges on the inside here. I'm going to take either a small diamond hone like this Easy Lap diamond hone, or even a tongue depressor with some real fine grit paper on it. This is a 300 or 400 grit paper. And what we want to do is we want to go inside this housing right here and clean all these edges up and flatten them out, take all the high spots off. So it's very easy. We just want to go in basically and polish all this like this. Now this is a soft metal, fairly soft metal. This is probably an injection aluminum or an injected pot metal. So we don't have to work at this very hard. We just want to take all the rough edges off and smooth them down. I want to go in along these edges here. I'm going to go in at a little bit of an angle because there's sharp edges here. I just want to knock these sharp edges off. Like that. Kind of give a little bit of a chamfer to it there. That's all there is to that. Now when you get all done, take a Q-tip and go in and clean the sanding grit and the dirt out of there. It's even a good idea to take a little bit of gun cleaner, WD-40 or something like that, put it on a Q-tip, and go in and make sure you've got all the grit and dirt and everything cleaned out of there. Like that. Now we're going to move on to the trigger. The trigger release, or the trigger safety, has got a little spring there to it, and a little pin that goes through right here. We shove this little pin out. And there's the trigger release, the spring, and the pin that holds it all together there. I'm going to set those aside for right now. What I want to show you next, we're going to hone on the trigger here a little bit. Now, the same thing with this trigger. What we want to do is smooth the sides down, make sure there's no high spots on it. So you can get your diamond hone and just get it over on these sides, get it nice and flat, and just buff it out a little bit. So we have all the high spots knocked off, any burrs or anything that's on it. Just like that. The next thing we want to do, we want to measure our clearance on the trigger assembly. You'll probably buy a four-piece kit when you order these shims. Four different sizes of shims, or four different thicknesses of shims. Actually, it's an eight-piece kit, and it'll have four different thicknesses. And I think we're going to have probably something really close to what you need by having a four-piece kit here. But what we're going to do is we're going to just take a set of standard automotive feeler gauges, the kind like you get down at the hardware store, or the auto parts store, or out in your toolbox. And what we want to do is we want to go in here and take our feeler gauge in and see how much room we've got, how much clearance we've got between the trigger and the housing in there. Now, I could slide a 10,000ths feeler in there very easily. So I'm going to step up to 11. And 11 also is very easy to insert. Go up to a 12,000ths. That goes in very easy. Up to a 13. And that's starting to get really snug there. And I know I've already checked this, and a 14 will not go in. So we're going to say that's 13,000ths here on this trigger. So we've got 13,000ths clearance. We want to leave about 3 to 4 thousandths clearance when we're done. Our ending clearance is going to be 3 to 4 thousandths. Our beginning clearance was 13,000ths. So what we want to do with this trigger assembly is we want to take 10,000ths of play or slop out of this trigger assembly with a set of shims. Now this is, it happens to be marked red, a set of 5,000ths shims. These are right out of the package. You'll get, if you buy an 8-piece set, you're going to get a set of 2s, a set of 3s, a set of 4s, and a set of 5s. We're going to take these are stampings. These shims, I make these on, with a stamping dies, and we just want to knock the little bit of a fine edge, if it's got any fine edge on it, off of them. And it just takes a second to do that with the hone. Now if you take a look at that, I've knocked any of the burrs or stamping flashing off of it, and that shim's ready to use. You don't have to do this. It's not necessary. The very little bit of stamping flash that's on there will wear off on its own very quickly, and there's really not enough there to worry about. But if you're a fanatic like I am, you just do this real quick. It takes a second, and you've got a very, very smooth fitted shim. You can even take your really, if you've got a real fine Arkansas hone like I've got, you can even take your trigger and just make sure it's nice and smooth on both sides. That's all there is to that. Now we want to reassemble this and put the shims in it. So let's set the, I'm going to put the trigger release in first. Set your spring in that little hole right there. Bring your release up in. This is almost a two-handed job, but we'll see if I can do it here. And just slide that pin back in place just like that. Now the next thing we want to do put our trigger return spring back in. Now, like I said, guys, we took the time to clean all this out with a hone, and then we went back in with a Q-tip and cleaned everything out, cleaned it up, or flushed out with some gun oil. Slide that spring into that little pocket right there. Maybe you can see that down in there. Now this little pin, there's not anything holding this little pin in on your trigger assembly other than when it gets inside this housing. The housing will hold it in place. So I've kind of got to guide this. I've got to go in and go against that spring and push forward and then go up into the sear. And there you can see the sear right through this little window right here. Okay, once we get it up in there, we kind of got to hold it in place. What I want to do is I want to get I've got a little cheater pin. If you buy an 8-piece kit, you're going to get it with a little cheater pin here. We're just going to shove a little cheater pin in like that. There we go. Now that's going to make it a lot easier to put the shims in, a little cheater pin is. You can do it without it, but it's a lot easier with it, and I'll show you why. First, we're going to start, we'll get a... push this little pin over till it's just past this line here in the trigger housing. There we go. We'll get our shim in here. Now we had 10/1000ths of room. When we started, so we're going to put a 5/1000ths on each side, slide this right into place there. Now we're going to take our regular trigger cross pin, we're going to come back in from this side and work it in gently, because you can damage that shim. You can go in with your pin and push too hard and bend the edges of the shim. We don't want to do that. And get it pushed in there, and we've got the shim trapped. Just wiggle the trigger a little bit until we shove the trigger pin in, and we shove the little cheater pin out. Now push this back. So now I pushed it back, so we've got the pin's not in the way on this side right here, so we can shove this other shim in. There's our other shim. You want to slide that in place. And that's all there is to it. That, just slide the trigger pin back in. Get the E-clip. Now you saw me struggle with this a little bit to start when I took it off. They're little tiny guys and they will go flying, so be careful. That back on there. There we go. Now you can use a little grease on your trigger where your shims go and stick the shims to it and slide them in. It's a little bit harder to do, but you can do it if you don't have the cheater pin. When you get all done, you want to come in here on both sides right here and put a little drop of oil, just a little drop, one drop is plenty, and work it in there. Work it back and forth. But now we've taken all the side-to-side slop. We've done a couple different things. Number one, we've taken the sharp edges out and the high spots and all the grit and everything from inside the trigger assembly and smoothed that off. We've smoothed off both sides of the trigger. And now we've taken all the excess play. And we've gotten it down to about 3/1000ths clearance, which is just right. So now we're going to have a nice smooth feeling trigger there. So if you go ahead and loosen up your trigger adjustment right here and lower the trigger pull weight on your trigger, you're really going to notice by having those shims in how much smoother that is. It's going to center the trigger better and just give you a much, much nicer trigger. Now this set of shims will work with all Ruger American rifles. I've got another video that we're going to do on the 450 Bushmaster Ranch Rifle, Ruger American Ranch Rifle, and it's exactly the same. Everything about that is the same. So if you've watched this video closely, you don't need to watch that one. But this shows you how to install the shims, how to measure for them, how to hone both sides, and that's all there is to it. Hey folks, thanks for watching today. I appreciate it. I hope this helps you. I appreciate your taking time to watch our video and stop by our web store, TriggerShims.com, and have a look at my products. Till then, take care, good shooting, and God bless. And in the same way, we're going to push the little E-clip off carefully because it will fly, and I'm going to cover it with my finger. Oh, there it went, right there. Took off like a cricket.